Welcome to the big, tiny food face-off!
A cooking competition where young chefs with big dreams compete to cook the world's smallest food. We're talking miniature kitchens, big steaks, and of course, tiny food. A super small art form that's become one of the biggest food crazes on the planet. That's right, tiny food has taken the internet by storm, inspiring a whole new generation of young chefs. But we're taking it to the next level. Our tiny kitchens are packed with one-of-a-kind tiny tools.
The first thing that I noticed on the tiny set was how small the kitchens were.
They had like a little fridge, little cabinets. All the materials that we used, like the spoons, whisks, the frying pans were so tiny. I was not expecting it to be that tiny.
Each teensy-weensy challenge will be judged by me, food vlogger Inga Lam, and YouTube superstar Matt Stonie, who may be known for eating big, but here, he's the king of tiny. Today, our three young chefs head to the great outdoors in two challenges, Give Me S'more and Campfire Classics. It's the biggest moment of their young lives, and we will be crowning a winner. Oh, and stay tuned for some secret guests. Here's a hint, they're furry and 3 inches tall.
It's time to tiny!
Our chefs are already hard at work.
For the first challenge, we've asked the chefs for a new take on a campfire treat that goes back for 100 years.
We're making s'mores today, baby. And the winner of this challenge gets an advantage in the final round.
The chefs have 30 minutes to complete their s'more-inspired dish.
Inga, let's get to know our chefs.
Let's do it.
My name is Gabriel Golub. I'm 11 years old, and I'm from Los Angeles, California. So I'm from Ukraine, and the city I'm from is Odessa. Everyone knows how to cook there. That's why I've been cooking from such a young age. I was like 3, and I was helping my grandma in the kitchen, making borscht or something like that.
My name is Shri Mayagala. I'm 13, and I'm from Owensboro, Kentucky. When I cook, I'm just in the zone. I forget everything else. It's my happy place. I don't have any other hobbies or obsessions because this is my obsession. What I love about making tiny food is you get to see other people's reactions when you make this food. They're like, oh my gosh, it's so cute. And I'll be like, yep, I made that.
Hi, my name is Madison Davis. I'm 13 years old and I live in Gardena, California. My family would describe me as fun, nice, and sometimes energetic. I first started getting into cooking because my sister watches a lot of cooking shows and I thought that was really cool. So then I started to make my own things. Then I decided maybe I'll try to do it tiny. I would say I'm kind of a creative person because I do really like drawing. The best thing about making tiny foods is that you can be really creative.
Stonie and I would judge their s'mores based on staying within scale, taste, and how well they showcase each chef's personal style.
So I'll be making a croquembouche, and that's a French dish. It's profiteroles stuffed with custard, and you would just take one out and then eat it. I think a real size croquembouche would be something like this. But since it's so tiny, I'll be making little graham cracker little balls to stick onto the waffle cone with melted marshmallows. I'll be finishing it all off with chocolate.
For this challenge, I'm making chocolate chip sandwich cookie s'mores with a peanut butter cup. I named it because that's what it was, chocolate chip sandwich cookie s'mores. I'm really worried about my dough getting sticky because that's happened before. I don't want that to happen.
For challenge one, I'm making a s'mores cake. I'm putting a vanilla cake, marshmallow frosting, then a chocolate cake, more marshmallow frosting, and toasted marshmallows on top. When making tiny foods, it's pretty hard to get the right measurements to make sure it has the right texture and everything.
5 minutes left, you guys. Only 5 minutes.
My marshmallow kept on falling off the stick. I had to keep on getting new marshmallows, which was really annoying.
So the dough for the graham cracker balls is burning. And I'm like, what should I do? And I'm like, okay, I'll make more dough. Hopefully that comes out well.
I kept on thinking I need to make sure I oil the pan because the cakes wouldn't come out the pan right and it would just not work out.
Oh, good.
For my croquembouche, I'm finishing it all off with chocolate, of course, because s'mores, it's graham crackers, marshmallow, and chocolate.
All right, chefs, time is almost up. 1 minute left.
We have to do this toast to marshmallow. Oh, come on, marshmallow.
She just...
So when I dropped stuff, I was like, really? The hardest thing about tiny food is actually the size of it. Everything is so small. You keep on dropping it. You saw how many times I dropped that.
10.
9.
8.
7.
6.
5.
4.
3.
2.
1.
And 0. Put down your cooking tools, tiny chefs.
Oh God, what a mess. I still have to look. No, I can't look.
Here's a tip for you. The key to making the perfect s'more is to cook the marshmallow fast on high heat so it's crispy on the outside and then soft and gooey on the inside.
All right, chefs, I think it is safe to say that your skills today have impressed the heck out of all of us here. Shrimaya, come show us your delicious tiny food.
Tell us what we have here.
So I made cookies, and then I put a chocolate peanut butter cup on it, and then I cut down a mini marshmallow, as it wasn't small enough. I can eat cookies in my sleep, so I put those on top.
Yeah, let's dig in.
Cheers.
Peanut butter and chocolate.
Right away, it's the peanut that comes through. The texture of it, not too doughy. It's like kind of has a bit of a chew to it that goes really well with the marshmallow.
The cookie was cooked perfectly. It crumbled just as you'd want it to.
Do you feel like you're eating a s'more, but cookie version?
100%.
Right? Thank you.
Thank you.
Gabriel.
You ready? Look at the little tower of cookies. Holy moly.
What is that?
What you see here is a croquembouche, only s'more croquembouche.
Croquembouche.
What is a croquembouche?
A croquembouche is like a tower of...
puff pastry.
Yes. And it has this cream, which actually the cone itself is filled with the cream.
Then you have the cookies, and then you have the drizzle.
Yeah.
Okay, well, here you go.
Chocolate, marshmallow.
I'm getting so much of the cone.
Right? The cookies. I like that you pivoted and made it into like a more like graham cracker texture. A little grainy. I kind of love the chew that the marshmallow gives again.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And you like your s'mores also like extra gooey.
Oh, I love my marshmallows nice and golden.
Ooh. Gabriel, I just want to say you should be very proud of yourself
very
for being able to pull that off in such a short time.
Thank you, Gabriel, so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, Madison.
Here it comes.
Oh, Mike, look at this.
Wow.
Please describe this to us.
It's vanilla cake on the bottom, marshmallow buttercream, then a chocolate cake, more buttercream, and then I cut up the marshmallows, and then I blowtorched it. Because that's like my favorite part of s'mores is the roasted marshmallow.
I love that. You really like kind of channeled the camping spirit. I've never had a cake to myself, I just want to say.
I have.
Of course you have.
Okay.
Are you being transported to like camping right now? That roasted marshmallow flavor that you were talking about really comes out.
Perfect golden marshmallow that you cook on the campfire, one that you're proud of.
And then the cake, kind of fluffy, you get that too. The only thing I will say is though, I could not taste the difference between the vanilla and the chocolate, but it was very, very good bite.
Oh, yeah. Very good bite.
Okay, thank you.
All right, chefs, your skills today have impressed the heck out of all of us. I mean, all three of your dishes were fantastic and delicious, but we had to choose the big winner of today's tiny challenge.
For being able to downsize their dessert perfectly, give us incredible taste, and showcase a little bit of their personality. Our winner for this first challenge is... Madison with her incredible s'more cake. Congratulations. Great job.
And now it's time for my favorite part of the show. Let's give a taste to our special guests who will be helping us in the final challenge.
I would say I'm a pretty big hamster lover. So the opportunity to cook for them is like, wow. Maybe one of the hamster judges can come home with me and be my pet. Dad, can I keep one?
And now things are about to really heat up, as in fire, because that is what you are going to need to cook this next meal. Are you guys ready for Campfire Classics?
Yes, we are.
This challenge is for all the marbles and that beautiful number one Tiny Chef Golden Blender Trophy.
Chefs, your goal is to make a full Campfire Classic meal, but there's a twist. Stonie, why do you look so shocked? This is our show.
I was a little late to the production meeting this morning, my bad.
For this challenge, you will not be using the stove in front of you. Our hamster friends have three campfire tools, a griddle, a grill, and a Dutch oven.
So since Madison, you won, you get to assign the tools.
Going into the second challenge, I'm excited that I won the first one, but I'm a little nervous because I'm not as good at cooking as I am baking. I'm gonna give the griddle to Gabriel because I know he likes cooking more than baking.
Now this is my natural habitat.
And then I'll give Shamari the skillet.
Skillet, all right. And then you, Madison, get the Dutch oven.
Yes.
In this challenge, you will be judged based on your technique, innovation, and of course, flavor.
So you've got your tools. It is now time to cross the finish line.
Ready, set, go!
You only have 60 minutes to create your dish.
I decided to use the Dutch oven because I was planning to make a corn stew, and I feel like that's easier to make in a pot with sweet corn, heavy cream, lime, the potatoes, gorita cheese, cilantro, and the secret ingredient, cheese zest.
Oh, did you taste the chili powder?
I'm trying to make sure I get different kinds of flavors that go together, so I'm hoping that puts me up at the top.
All right.
At the tin, there's nothing more appropriate.
It does look very camping style.
So I'm gonna be making a marinated salmon in beetroot, which will give it a nice pink color. I went to Alaska this one time, and me and my dad, there were so many salmon. We were just catching one after another. And after that, we went camping and we made this amazing salmon dish. So that's how I got the inspiration. I'm also thinking of adding a pickled beetroot and then curl it up into making like a tulip or a rose looking figure.
My traditional dish in my country is something called borscht or red beet soup. So me and my grandma would cook that so much. So of course I would have always been using beet.
For the second challenge, I'm much more relaxed and I've gotten to know where everything is. So I feel like I'm gonna do much better. I'm making chicken skewers with red onions, green bell pepper, and a dip. For my dip, I have sour cream, mayo, garlic powder, and then I'm gonna sprinkle some dill weed on top to make it look pretty.
Madison, I need your chili powder.
Okay, here, bring it back.
I'm very confident this round because I know what I'm doing and I don't have to measure out all these ingredients. So I can just eyeball it, even though I'm not the best at that.
Shree, what's going on?
It's going great.
What is this seasoning over here?
So I have garam masala, salt, pepper, and chili powder.
Okay, can I smell it?
Yeah, go ahead.
Oh man, you gotta.
Oh man.
I think the judges are gonna really be blown away by the spices that they're gonna feel in their mouth.
Tell me more, is it your dad's recipe?
When we grill, we put some of the garam masala on top. I don't know what else he puts because it's a secret recipe.
Okay.
A little bit of a tough question here. Who would you say is the better chef? Yourself or your dad?
Me. Well, he like makes like traditional food.
Okay.
But I bake and stuff.
I'm all about confidence. New school versus old school.
That just left you asked.
Thank you.
She might. I saw she had a lot of flavors. I feel like in this round, the competition might be a little tough to beat. I need to make sure that all the vegetables are cooked all the way through because I don't want the judges to be eating raw vegetables.
I told you, it smells amazing at the station.
It does. So what is your inspiration behind this dish?
So my inspiration is roasted corn. Because like when you're camping, you roast things. And I actually really like these corn bowls. They're from Farmer's Market, and it has like corn, butter, cheese.
Oof, it's very camping feel.
Definitely.
Gabriel, tell me what you're doing right now. There's some bubbling going on here.
Yep. Oh. That's actually not too good.
The sauce was bubbling, and you really don't want the sauce to bubble, because it might mean that it's gonna get burnt.
What is in there? Is that dill?
That's dill with heavy cream and Parmesan.
So I was just like putting it on the stove, mixing it until it bubbled, then taking it off, still mixing it, and repeat that. And then I still got my sauce, so that's nice.
I know there's only a little bit, but I can smell it. It smells really good.
I have to cut a little toothpick. And then next, I have to stick those red onion, green bell pepper, chicken that I put spices on toothpick. And then I'm going to grill it over my campfire.
I need to be cooking the salmon correctly. I want all sides to be pretty much looking the same. If one side burns, that's gonna be horrible, because that burn, you're gonna taste that through all of the salmon because of how small it is.
Hopefully the judges will like my dish. Hopefully the hamsters, oh my gosh.
They will come after me if I don't do good. So I'm fighting for my life here, you know?
So I'm putting it on, but not putting it on here because I don't want it to burn.
My favorite tiny food tool to use is the tweezers because it makes things easier to put in the oven without burning myself.
Now I'm adding heavy cream just to make sure that it's creamy enough.
2 minutes left, everybody, 2 minutes.
So curling the rows, I've done this before, but like now making it even tinier, it might be somewhat difficult.
All right, chefs, count it down with me. 10.
9.
8.
7.
6.
5.
4. 3.
2.
1.
And that's it, everybody. Great job, everybody.
Great job.
All right, guys, this is the moment of truth.
Shamai, let's see your tiny dish. Wow, so gorgeous. Tell us about this dish.
These chicken skewers are inspired by my dad. Mm-hmm. And I put bell pepper and red onion.
The dip again was?
Sour cream, mayo, and dill weed.
I don't know what to say. I mean, these kebabs, they look like kebabs, just tiny.
I'm just so wowed by how you're able to get each piece almost like identical in size. Because that's like a big thing about skewers. You want them to be equally portioned out.
Yes. Right?
I think it's time for us to get a little taste. Oh my God.
I'll go for the dip.
Okay. Two skewers for two people.
Two skewers for two people.
Appreciate it very much.
Beautiful. Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, wow.
How does this tiny food have such big flavor? I cannot get over it.
In that tiny bite, there's so much, like, there's like the red onion and the green pepper and the chicken and the spices. It's like you get all of that at once. That's not something you can normally have. I love the way you kind of measured everything out so that everything is almost equal, and that's why everything just ties in together.
I'm still experiencing the flavors in my mouth,
right?
But I don't want
it's
the end.
Here. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, Gabriel, come on up. Show us what you got.
Look at that. Oh, it's so tiny.
So delicate, that rose.
What is the name of this dish?
Rosa salmon.
Okay, fancy. Tell us what we have here in this plate.
All right, so you have your salmon marinated in orange juice, beet juice, soy sauce, salt, pepper, sugar, the usual. On the left, that's the rose that's marinated in the same things, only with vinegar, red vinegar. The sauce, that's heavy cream with some dill, and there's also a glaze on top of the salmon made with the marinade that it was marinating in with a bit more sugar.
Ooh, okay.
There are many layers to this dish.
Yeah, you really know how to camp in style.
Gotta bring everything.
This is what they call a glamping nowadays.
Why sacrifice?
This looks so good.
I'm gonna go for the salmon first and then the roast. Get a little of the sauce.
Beautiful color. Oh, wow. I love the freshness of the beet and the texture of the fish.
Yeah, 100%. I'm gonna dig into this rose.
Okay.
There we go.
Here we go. All right, go for it.
Yeah, I'm not getting the bitterness. I mean, proportionally, it's a, you know, it's a very small portion.
Yeah, it might be because there's a lot of sauce on it.
True, true.
I love it when people make edible decorations because you can eat the entire thing. You should be really proud of yourself.
Thank you.
Madison! Last but not least, so what is this?
So this is corn elote stew. It's based on corn elote, which is like corn butter, and there's like different stuff on it. And I really like roasted corn, so that gives it like a better flavor, like with the butter. That's why it smelled really good over there. And then I finished it off with some cheese, cilantro, and
cheese. Yes.
So when can we dig in? Please, I can't wait any longer.
Go for it.
Go for it. Ah, challenge.
All right, well, cheers. Oh my God, it is creamy, it is spicy. Like it's a very slight, but you do get a little bit of that kick.
I could taste the cheese, the potatoes, the corn. For a stew, you got the consistency right. This is a stew, that's a stew. Small.
Yeah. You've really given us something to stew over.
It's now the moment of truth. We will select a winner
based on your technique, innovation, and of course, flavor. When it came to innovation, all of you knocked it out of the park. And then presentation, I've seen full-size dishes that don't even come to half of what you guys did today. You guys should be so proud of yourself. But when it comes to flavor, one of you really, really, really made this challenge your own.
And the big tiny food face-off. Number one, ultimate, grand champion of the entire universe is... Sarai! Congratulations.
Sarai, with your amazing skewers.
I'm a tiny food master.
Come and claim your golden blender trophy.
Yay!
Oh my gosh. I won. I seriously won. I can't believe it. I still have to pinch myself.
I was really proud of what I was able to accomplish in such a short amount of time. This was a really hard challenge, but I'm glad that I can do it.
Great job,
well
everybody.
Done, well
Thank
done,
you.
Well Amazing done, well done. You too.
The best thing about tiny food is when you finish, because you did all this effort to make it so tiny. It's like the best feeling in the world.
Tiny!